really done pretty well for me. So
it's been incredible. So how long have you been with It Works?
I just signed up in February.
You're incredible. Yep. Good job. Holy
yeah,
cow.
Yeah, I love it. It's great.
You are doing so good. I love it. I saw your addition today in the Boom, and I was like, freak, she's giving us a run for our money.
Girl, I'm pushing for that 1,000. I want to hit that $500 entry.
That's insane. Well, yeah, you guys. So give Brittany some competition here. Otherwise, she's getting that $500.
I mean, or don't.
Right. Either way.
No, either way. I do. I thrive. Bring it. Let's go. I welcome it. Let's go. I think it'll be great.
Oh my gosh, that's so good. Awesome. Well, cool. We've got 18 people on so far. I'm sure we'll get a few more people come in. We are wanting to talk about host to post today, you guys. And then stay at the very end. We're going to have a very, like a 10-minute Tough Love Tuesday. It was so good last Tuesday. I loved it. She even pumped me up. And so if you want to stay on for that, then just stay tuned at the very end. Sure. Tiffany's going to do that. So who wants to start? We have a few leaders that wanted to talk about host to post. Who wants to start? We've got Katie and Tiffany. Who else?
So
yeah, go ahead.
I was going to say I wasn't prepared to talk right now.
Jody making calls.
But so host to host. God, I wish Shelby was on here.
Like, what the fuck?
If everyone can mute yourself, please. Thank you.
Okay. So host to post is, it took me a minute to get on board with host to post, but I was talking to Colette earlier, and it's so amazing, especially for you new distributors, because it allows you guys to get outside of your inner circle. One huge thing that you can do for your business is building up your audience. So by doing host to post, it allows you to reach into other people's markets. And let me just go back. Let me backtrack a little bit with host post. So basically what you're doing is you are asking your warm market to host a post for you, meaning share a post on their newsfeed. And you're basically, so in other words, I'm reaching out to Brittany and I'm saying, hey girl, will you, I'm doing a drawing right now for a Roomba. All you have to do is share a post for me on your page. I will provide you with the verbiage and a graphic. Are you interested in that? Brittany, of course, is going to say, yeah, she doesn't have to come out of the pocket anything. She's not going to lose anything. All she has to do is share a post. So I'm going to provide her with the verbiage and a graphic. You can do any product that you want to do. The ones that I've been doing lately, of course, Cleanse is always great. I've been doing Cleanse Keto Coffee, and I've been doing three different package options. One is the Thermofit with Fat Fighters, and Thermofit Fat Fighters and Greens. And I feel like there's another package. Oh, Hair, Skin, and Nails. So you can get them different options there. As your friend posts on their newsfeed, they're going to tag you. So you're going to get notified anytime somebody comments on that post. You're going to go send them a friend request. So you're expanding your audience. And then you're going to personally send them a message. So you're going to comment, hey, I'm going to send you information. You're going to message them, and you're going to carry on a conversation on the sideline. So that's great for new people because you're expanding your audience and you're getting the opportunity to enroll your first 4 loyal customers. So that's all I will start with there. Does anybody else have any more input as far as host to post?
Well, and yeah, so if you're new, it's a great, like she was saying, it's a great way to expand your audience. But then for us seasoned people, it's a great way to reach out to our loyal customers and say, you've been such a loyal customer. I've loved having you and your loyalty. We're offering a free prize this month. It's valued at almost $200. Do you want to get entered? This would mean a lot to me. So let's see. Oh, okay. So Katie says she's signing someone up. She'll help in like 5 minutes. Awesome. Sign someone up, Katie. Ashley, I run into so many people who don't respond to me when I tell them that there's a post to be entered. That's normal. And that's why it is on average, and Tiffany, you can correct me with your numbers if I'm wrong, but it's about 10% of people that are going to say yes. And so that's why if we only ask 10 people, hey, will you host a post for me? You're probably going to get one person that says yes. And so that's normal. And that's even normal for ambassadors. It's normal for people who are rocking it with enrollment. So I was talking with a girl yesterday who she has enrolled over 100 customers last month. And she says the same thing. She's on Instagram and on Facebook. She's always adding new people. And she's always letting people know about their drawing and asking about 100 people a day, do they want to be in her host-to-post drawing? And so if you're thinking, okay, I want to have 5 posts a day going on host-to-post. If you have 5 posts a day, maybe you want 2 posts a day, then you know that you need to, it's about 10%. You need to ask about that many people to be hosting a post for you. And so if you're asking 20 people a day, then about 2 are going to be saying yes. And if you're doing that consistently, Monday through Friday, Monday through Saturday, then you're going to have about 12 people, 10 to 12 people a week that are doing a host a post for you. But the same, like the numbers is the same, whether you're they're interested in a product and then they ghost you for a while. They're interested. They're just either busy. Maybe they forgot to respond to the message and that's why we do follow-ups. Maybe they're a little bit nervous. And so with Ashley, talking about it, when she says, when I tell them that they have to make a post, sometimes people don't want to put a post on their wall. I have a friend who actually just made a post on Facebook. I love her to pieces. But she made a post saying, if I get one more network marketer, MLM person that asks me to post for them, she's like, I want to be everyone's friend. I want to have lots of friends that offer something to everyone. She's super big into keto and to fitness. And she's like, I want to be able to help other people, but don't just ask me to host a post if you've never even had a conversation with me. And if you have a conversation with me, you'll probably know that's probably not something that I'm willing to do, because she doesn't add any. She's very picky about her supplements. And I know that by following her. And so it's like, know your audience, but maybe the wording, maybe we can help you with the wording. So with Ashley, she asked, they don't respond after you ask that they have to make a post. Maybe you can share a screenshot with your upline and say, hey, this is what I said to them. Is there a way that I can improve how I'm asking them to post for me? So sometimes the way we word it might come across either super casual, which makes them less nervous, or maybe it makes them super nervous that, oh no, maybe we're going to be super salesy. And so sometimes I like to voice memo and say, oh my gosh, it's just super easy. I'll just give you some wording. I'm looking for a few more people who are excited about losing weight. You don't have to do anything. If there's anyone who's interested, I'll just kind of follow up with them. So you don't have to do anything. And so when it's a voice memo, they can hear, oh, it's no big deal. Or maybe if it's written in a way, they think it's no big deal, but there's still going to be some people who don't want to post on their wall, and that's okay.
Can I say one thing? I saw Brianna ask, she said, can you touch on who to ask?
Yeah.
So in my book, and I know everybody probably does it different ways, there's 3 different ways that I ask. I have a 100s list that, and these are people that I actually know, people that I've actually you know, kind of grown to have a relationship with. I can reach out to anybody on my 100s list and ask them if they'd be willing to host a post for me. I also post on my page something quick and simple. I'll post a picture of the Roomba and just say, next 50 people get an entry into my drawing. Those people are going to drop, you know, emojis or gifts or whatever into my thing. And that's just kind of a way for me to know, okay, I'm going to reach out to this person, because in my eyes, you want a Roomba, you want an entry, but what are you willing to do for that? I'm going to give you an option, an opportunity to get an entry. So that's what I'm going to ask them to host a post. They can choose to or not choose to do it for me. Usually, if they've already commented on my post, 9 times out of 10, they're going to say yes, because they're not losing out on anything. They're not having to buy anything. The other people that I ask are people who have shown interest. So say I'm showing before and after pictures, or I'm putting things in my stories, and they ask about how much it is. They're not ready to buy yet. I ask those people, okay, that's fine, but I'm also running doing a drawing at the end of the month. How would you like to get an entry? So those people who are not interested in buying right now, they have nothing to lose. So it's, you know, look at different ways that you can reach out to these people to ask them to host the post for you. Again, they're not losing anything. They're not paying for anything. All they have to do is share a post on your page. So if they're not responding to you, then, I mean, no harm, no foul. You're not losing anything. They're not losing anything. But just look at different avenues of how you can reach out to them.
Yeah, I love that. So Moto Z3 says, how do I change the algorithm? And Tanya replies, engaging is what changes the algorithm. Go through and comment on everyone's page or post. You can go A through Z on your friends list. If you need help, that we can help you. So the other thing with asking, so yeah, I saw Shelby said, and I was like, she's going for it. Shelby posted the next 80 people who comment an emoji can get entered in for this Roomba. And she has all these people commenting, and I'm like, holy cow, there's so many people. There is also, with everyone who's been liking and commenting on your regular post, there is a myth, you guys. Many people get frustrated or discouraged when you don't get a lot of interaction on your It Works posts. That's fine. Don't worry about it. If you are getting some good interaction on your personal posts, your engagement posts of questions that you're asking, Tiffany posted about her boyfriend. Oh, I'm sorry. I just said it so lightly. I know Luke Perry died. I'm genuinely sad, and I wasn't trying to make light of it, but all these people were commenting because she had this picture of him and her together, but it was like Photoshop. You guys, that's the engagement that you want to see. You want to see engagement on your personal stuff, and that's giving you the thumbs up that people love you, people are seeing your stuff. If you weren't getting any engagement on your personal stuff either, that's when we really need to work on it and figure out how can we help you get that engagement up. And so you can even go through your personal posts and say, you know what, you've been an amazing friend. You're always showing love on my posts. Can I ask you a favor? Will you be willing to put a post on your wall? And I will, just for doing that, I'm going to put you in my drawing for this Roomba. Would that be okay? Like, do whatever it takes, but that means stepping out of your comfort zone in a friendly way. Tiffany, is your hand raised? It kind of is.
That was before I spoke.
Okay.
But I kind of had to jump in because you didn't see my hand was raised. So I'm okay. Going to lower.
Brittany says, I found asking your previous loyal customers to be something that gets more yes answers. Absolutely. So you guys, I have a private group just for my loyal customers that I like to go in there and put the specials, ThermoFidex, a couple before and after pictures. Like, I keep my loyal customers interested, and I go in there and I tell them, hey, you guys, would anyone be willing to post on their wall? let them know about BOGO. You know, it's just a great place to kind of have it all together, even though the Connect app can also do the same thing for you. Jess says, I've got people to comment on my post about how my health is doing. Absolutely. So I know that Jess has been struggling with her health lately and people have been very, very concerned. That's something that you, Jess, can go through genuinely, sincerely, and message every one of them personally and say, you know what? Thank you. Thank you for caring. That means a lot to me. Let that be it. Let them reply. If you continue to carry on a conversation, say, you know what? Would you be willing to do me a favor? It should not be right out the gates, but it should be this back and forth conversation for a while, and then interject and say, it would mean a lot to me. Would you be willing to do this?
I really thank you for saying that. You're literally bringing tears to my eyes, because you guys don't know, as my health has been really bad. I was diagnosed when I was in the hospital for a week. I was diagnosed with pneumonia, heart failure, and I have PVCs, and I'm getting better, but it's just taking time, and I really appreciate everybody. It's just saying that just brings tears to my eyes, and I really, really thank you guys for being really supportive. But I'm back on track now and trying my best.
And you're here, so thank you for being here, and we're cheering you on.
Again.
Yep. Katie, do you want to add to suggestions about host a post? And I don't know if you were listening where someone, I mean, there's been some chat of what do you do when people say, or they don't respond after you've said, will you make a post on my page? Or, you know, talk about the numbers game, like how many people are you messaging? So if you want to share a little bit.
So I'm the total opposite of everybody in what they just said. I'm the person who, I have 5,000 friends on my Facebook, and that's just crazy. And so I am in the process of weeding that out. So what am I doing to weed that out? I'm trying to find the people that are genuinely there to support me. And I think I said this the last team meeting that I was on, because if someone's first response to you is no, then that just shows me that if it's no, or, you know, they don't even respond or whatever, that just shows me that they're not in support of what you do, regardless of, you know, what it is you're messaging them about. So for me personally, I have been working my letter chart every single day, with multiple different hosts of posts. Like I have, I think like 6 sheets going on right now of just different hosts of posts that I've been doing. That there was one day I had 16 active posts, that I was working on messaging people through. But literally I am just messaging as many people per day as I can without going into messenger jail. I've already been there once. So it's a little frustrating when you're in there. So, within reason, I'm doing it. Shelby sent me a really good, wording. I'll pull it up real quick and just kind of give you an idea of what I'm messaging to everybody. And I send this out to everybody. I don't even care if I've never had a conversation with you or if I have had a conversation with you. For me right now, because of the size of my friends list on on Facebook, I'm just trying to look for those diamonds in the rough, the people who are ready to support, who have been watching me for a while. And I'm ready to just kind of pull them out. So I don't know how many of you have this wording, but Shelby sent this to me the first day in March. And basically it goes like this. It says, hey girl, super random. I'm sure you get messages a lot, and I hope you don't mind me messaging you with some funny emojis, but I have a quick question. If I sent you a status, would you share it for me? It's short, sweet, nothing spammy with a, you know, an LOL emoji. If you get 2 customers from your post, I'll give you a free sample pack of keto skinny coffee. detox greens, a keto and a keto energy pixie stick. Plus, for posting, you'll be entered into our monthly drawing. The drawing for last month was a Fitbit. This month will be a Roomba vacuum with a like, oh wow face. And then it says, does that interest you? And honestly, that wording right there, I have gotten a lot of response from. And it's because it's not in your face, hey, host a post for me. It's, you know, recognizing, hey, I understand that you probably get these a lot. And I totally get it that if you don't want to do it, that's fine. But here's what I want to give to you in return for doing this for me. And a lot of people have been like, ooh, I can get free products if two of my friends sign up. That is so cool. Yeah, I'd love to post that for you. So I've had a lot of really good luck with this. And really for me, it's just a numbers game. The more people I find myself, the more people I am messaging a day, the more my list is growing. Like this, we're only on day, what, five? And I have, these are all just new potentials. I have 68 potentials right now, just from the host of posts that I've been doing. And like, believe me, guys, I am not a very organized person, but I'm determined this month to be organized. And, you know, I had a conversation with Shelby because I want to go diamond. I am going diamond this month. That is my goal. And I'm going to do it. So what did I need to do it? And Shelby and I talked, and we decided that I'm 100% committing to host a post this month. So what does that mean for me to do? It means any possible chance that I get outside of my 40-hour job, I'm going to sit down and I'm going to message people, and I'm going to continue to message people and get these potentials. And then on Fridays are my follow-up days. So then I'm going to go back through and I'm going to hit all of these people that have said, you know, they're interested in, and, you know, message them again and say, hey, you know, I'm signing up a bunch of people right now because so many people want these products. I know you were interested in X, Y, and Z. Are you ready to get signed up? I have some time right now available to do that. So that's how I'm going about it. I know that's completely a different way than what everybody else has been saying, but really, you guys, you have to find what works for you. You know, what Tiffany's saying may work better for some of you. What I'm saying may work better for some of you. What Colette's saying may work better for some of you. What I have found through this company is you really just have to go for it. You have to try everything and be willing to step, you know, like Colette said, step outside of your comfort zone. You know, when I first started last year, I would have never messaged people like this because I was afraid of that one person that's going to be like, why are you messaging me like this? Like, why are you talking to me when we've never had a conversation like this before? And now I'm at the point where it's like, I don't care. There's a block button and I can block you if you're going to be rude, you know, because a simple no or, you know, I'm not interested would suffice instead of, you know, people being rude. So don't be afraid of that. Don't be afraid of, you know, having a conversation with somebody who's rude, because 9 times out of 10, when you're afraid of that, that's when it's going to happen. When you're not afraid of it is when possibilities will happen. And if you guys haven't watched the podcast that Colette shared the other day, oh my God, you guys, you have to, like 100%. And I am not a religious person by any means, but I loved her podcast. Absolutely loved it. I listened to it in my car probably 6 times. And I was like, this is amazing, because she hits a lot of really, really good points about game planning. You have to plan for 90% of what your goal is and leave that extra 10% for the magic to happen. Because if you truly believe in what you're going to do and you truly believe in what you can accomplish, then that magic will happen. And You know, it goes back to everything we've always said. It's your mindset. If you are telling yourself that you can't do something, you won't do it. If you tell yourself you can do it and you are going to do it, you 100% will achieve that goal. So just keep that in mind when you're going about things. And please, please, please don't hesitate to use your leadership. We're here for a reason. If I don't have an answer for you, I'm going to go, you know, to Tiffany or Colette or, you know, Brianna or Shelby and get that answer for you. But make sure that you're reaching out to us, because if you're not asking questions and you're not reaching out for different ways of being able to talk to people, then you're not growing in your business. You're not taking in new opportunities to do something a different way. So please, I've been preaching this to my team all since, you know, I don't even know, probably a couple months now. Jess is shaking her head because she knows. I preach this all the time. Use me. That's what I'm here for. Use your leadership. That's what we're here for. You know, my team knows if you can't reach me, go to Shelby, because, you know, sometimes during the day I can't message you just because of my work. And they know they go to Shelby, and of course Shelby's amazing with everything, but Shelby created a bunch of groups for that reason. So, other than that, I mean, if you guys have other questions about kind of how I do my host to post or what I'm doing right now, I'm always available. Shoot me a message and I can certainly answer that for you.
Okay. And so we're going to come back to you, Katie, in just a second, but I want to touch on that podcast that I shared. You guys, it was fantastic. And like she was saying, yeah, there's a very spiritual, I wouldn't say undertone. It's very present in her podcast, but her message was phenomenal. And I wrote down the 4 points. There's 4 points to help you achieve your goals, for you to find success in whatever you're looking for. And so number one, set a goal on how you will get there. So number one, you need to know what your goal is. You have to know what your goal is. It has to be specific. You need to know that you are going Ruby by March 31st or March 15th. You have to know what that goal is and know what is necessary to get to that goal. She said up to 90%. You might not have some things in your control, but you have an idea of how you're supposed to get there. And you don't have to worry about the how, but you have to worry about the details of what you need, not how. So set a goal on what you need to get there and figure it out about 90% of the way. Then step number two, do it even when you don't feel like it. That one is huge for us in our side gig, network marketing, working from home job. This is not easy to do it when you're feeling sick, when you're feeling depressed, when you are busy. I've been waking up. Yesterday it was at 5 a.m. to do a power hour, and today I'm doing them at 6 a.m. because 5 a.m. is just too early for me. 6 a.m. to do a power hour with whoever wants to hop on. And I had two wonderful women on this morning, and we had a great power hour. And we didn't feel like it. I would much rather have been sleeping in my bed than doing my work session. But how can I get closer to my goal if I'm taking the easy route, doing it when I feel like it? So you need to do it no matter what. Number three is probably one of the hardest, but I love this. Practice believing that you will achieve. So practice believing that you will achieve no matter what, even when you haven't shown up for the goal. What? So you can say, well, I haven't shown up for my goal. I haven't done anything. So you no longer believe. You've got to practice believing that it's going to happen no matter what, that you're going to go diamond no matter what, even if you didn't fully show up for your goal. You got to change your mindset, though. You got to be like, I'm going there and I'm going to do it no matter what. I'm going to work even though I don't feel like it. And I know what I need to get there because you did number one. But the number four, make room for the magic. You have to have absolute space and belief that there is a way that this is going to happen, even though you don't have all the answers. And I find that so beautiful that you're going to achieve this. And it might not be all on your own. It might be the universe or God or your team or whatever, but there's going to be things that come into play that's going to help you get there if you simply just believe. So with that being said, you guys, I want to do, if there's nothing else that needs to be talked about, I want to do about 15 minutes of actual work on host to post. And Katie, can you copy paste that wording? Did you have that somewhere where you can put it in the chat?
Yeah, I can copy that. I'll send you guys the whole actual HAP because it's it's upselling the cleanse and the skinny mocha together. So yeah. I'll send that in the chat here so everybody has it. Just give me.
Okay. So while everyone is waiting for her to get that wording, what I want you to do is commit in your mind that for 15 minutes, we are going to get at least 15 messages sent out to people. And I want you to either get your hundreds list out. I want you to get out loyal customers, friends and family, or you're going to go through the alphabet. Whatever it is, you are going to find 15 people to send out messages to host a post. And I want you to commit on the side, say, yes, you're doing this. I want you to be like, okay, let's do it. Barbie says yes. Katie, heck yes. Oh, all the yeses, I can't keep up. Awesome. Okay.
Okay, guys, I'm going to send the post in the chat. It's going to come into two different parts because it won't let me send everything all at once. So just keep in mind. And if you guys have any questions on how it's actually supposed to go, just let me know and I can kind of explain it a little bit more. But that's part one. And then this is part two. It should flow pretty well. And again, when I send these out as my name, it usually in it. So just make sure that wherever you save it to, you're editing it to be you. I change words to make it sound more like me. You can do the same as well. Or you can leave it like this and just change the name. That's totally up to you. But let me know if you guys have any questions on any of it. And I would honestly copy and paste this and save it somewhere and throw some emojis in there. I'm an emoji queen usually, like when it comes to responding. So I like to throw a bunch in there just because it gets people engaged. Go from there, I guess. But if you guys have questions, just let me know.
Okay. So I'm also going to copy this and I'm going to put it on in my host to post section. And let's see. If it's already in our team page, we can re-bump it, or maybe we can even make it as an announcement. And if it's not, then maybe we should put it in there as well. Hey, you guys, so what we're doing right now, I want everyone to be messaging a minimum of 15 people. That's all we're going to be working on right now. And when you're done, I want you to comment in the chat saying done. Okay.
Sorry, guys, there was a little bit more that got cut off, so I just sent it. So just replace like the last part with the message that I just sent.
I'm going to turn on some music for about 10 minutes while we're working on this. Don't go anywhere, you guys. We're going to end. We're still going to close it up, and we still need to take a picture later, too. So don't go anywhere.
working 24 hours, 24 hours with you. We spent the weekend getting even more. And the late nights making things right between us. Now it's all good, babe, but I'm not good, babe. These girls like to go around, girls like this, and now when I'm on the road, I need a girl like to say, yeah, girl like to the fun, let me do what I want, when I'm on the road, I need a girl like to say, yeah, 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 yeah.
I'm really trying to think. way it was working was, it was still on camera. I was on the other side, just directing it, so I was shouting, playing the lyrics, holding up the lyrics, and then I'd occasionally run in.
One time on Twitter, I heard Ariana was pregnant, so I got pregnant at the same time. Turns out it was just a rumor.
Ariana Grande, my hair looks sexy. She's not wrong.
Ariana broke off an engagement, so I found a guy to propose to me. I broke off an engagement.
I just love it. And now I'm doing some chick called Aubrey.
Hey, so how are you guys doing? Did everyone get some people messaged?
Well, and
what was that?
I did.
Good. How about Morgan? You got three yeses?
Well, the thing is, I got kind of a rude message.
And we'll get that. And you know what? We have to just let it roll off. And some people aren't going to be patient or understanding, and we have to like not let it bother us. Ashley Dunn. Okay. Good job. I got a yes already. I got a thumbs up and yes. Amanda's done. Morgan, I'm really happy that you got three yeses. How does that make you feel?
This is so exciting. I can't, like, nobody ever responds, like, for, like, hours whenever I post stuff.
I love it. I'm excited for you. And so just continue to use that kind of the step-by-step wording that that Katie shared. There's a lot of different wording that we've shared, but it's like we keep learning with our wording. And so just work with what feels good, makes sense, and you can see how the wording itself can make a difference sometimes. And I do love her wording here. Shelby says, just go on to the next. Not everyone's going to be nice or say yes. And we can't give too much focus to the negative. Okay. So awesome. And I say really, really, like, Katie is on a mission, and she's going for diamond, and she's like, you know what, I don't care if people are going to be rude or if they don't respond. She has a lot of friends on her Facebook, and so she's weeding them out that way. All credit to Shelby. That's great. That's how we learn from one another, and we're all learning from you guys, so thank you very much. And that's why we also increase our friends list. We increase our audience. You can ask people on Instagram as well, and continue doing this. Okay. I love it. Do we have any other comments or questions? This is all about trying to help you guys feel focused and ready to go for this week. The no's are replaceable. Yep. Okay. You guys, let's take a picture really fast. Awesome. Cool. Thank you. Okay, so let's see. Shelby's saying, be sure that you're having people post. Oh, be sure the post that you're having people post, change it up. She'll do 5 thermal fight X and then 5 cleanse. Don't do the same one all day. Change up the algorithm. Absolutely. The date of the drawing for the Roomba, is that what we're asking about? Let me see what the calendar says. So we could do it on April 1st, on a Monday. Oops. Let me get back to the Zoom. Yeah, we can do it April 1st, if everyone's okay with that. All right, you guys. So those that want to stay on, Tiffany has some awesome things to close out the call, to close out the Zoom for our Tuesday night, Tough Love Tuesday, for that segment. I feel like it's a radio show. So for anyone who wants to stay on, she's getting ready to start that. Brittany. Oh, yeah, I know. So they don't think it's April Fools. Plus, we are seriously, you guys, many of you are going for big bonuses, and so we might be still a little bit frantic. So, okay, we'll say April 2nd. We'll say Tuesday, April 2nd. I'll make sure that there's an event so that you can add your participants to that. Okay. All right, so we'll hand it over to Tiffany.
Hi, ladies. So today I wanted to talk about what it means to be a networks distributor. You know, I remember a while back I was talking to one of my girlfriends who was also a distributor, and her teenage son walks in the room and he goes, you know, I just left In-N-Out and there was about 4 people there that had It Works shirts on and they were chowing down on burgers, fries, and shakes. He goes, your guys' products don't work. And so when he told me this, I was like I didn't know what to say. So now this is, I mean, you can't help what people see in public, but you can help what people see on your newsfeed. So we are in the health and wellness field and we need to portray that. We need to, I mean, even if you're not, I mean, honestly, the majority of us are nowhere near where we want to be weight-wise or how we look, but what we can put out there is our testimonial. We have health and wellness products, so what we need to do is choose which products of ours that we're going to be using to get there and use that. So we've got our auto shipment. If you want to start your testimonial with keto coffee, put that on your auto shipment. If you want to use Thermofy and Fat Fighters, put that on your auto shipment and have that be your focus to get where you want to be and post about your journey. So people are going to be watching you guys. You know, if you're new to this business, talk about what your goals are, how you want to lose 20 pounds or 30 pounds or however many pounds and how you're going to get there. Post about how you're taking your Thermofy as you're going to the gym, how you're drinking your grains, how you're wrapping on Wednesdays. This is what's going to get everybody's attention. So you've got to think about that when you're putting out your posts. Do research on how to meal prep, healthy ways of living, different diets. Research on the keto. We are huge with keto. So YouTube. Duh. Go to YouTube and research the keto diet. I research so many different people who are professionals with keto, and I learn about it because people are going to ask you about it, and you're going to want to be able to explain it to them. Learn how you can get on the keto diet as well as using our products. So you have to portray yourself like you are this you're in the health and wellness field, if somebody, because people are going to come to you and say, are you using the product? You can't step back and say, oh no, I haven't used anything, but I want to sell it. You want to be able to say, I've used this. This is my favorite flavor. I prefer salted caramel over the regular packets of keto coffee. I prefer greens, but I like the chocolate greens and my meal replacement shakes. You want to talk about the products in a way that people can kind of relate. So you have to turn this business into your lifestyle. So watch what you're doing. With anything that you're posting, we all have our cheat meals. You better be posting about those fat fighters if you're having a cheat meal. But try to refrain from sharing all these bad foods because people are going to jump on you for that. People love to jump on It Works distributors saying, oh, it doesn't work. They don't live that lifestyle. Don't give them a reason to jump on you for it. When you're posting, make sure it's not salesy. Don't go and Google It Works, join my team pictures and post those. You want to post lifestyle pictures, pictures of, you know, selfies of you. Post like heartfelt verbiage on your posts. We've got lots of places that you can get graphics from. Those of you that are new may not have a lot of products on hand, but you can go to our new, I say new because we've just changed it in the last couple of months. It's our It Works Global Instagram page, which is It Works Q. Go to that page and just kind of scroll through those posts, take screenshots of a lot of posts that you'd like to use, and crop them. Make sure you're cropping them. Hold on, I'm trying to keep track of our chats. Oh, Katie says, be careful of your selfies. Make sure it presents you in the best light to enhance what Tiffany is saying. Yes, the best light. Don't post a picture of you where you're it looks like you've got bags under your eyes. Sunlight is the best. Make sure the sunlight is coming towards your face. Make sure your pictures look good before you present them. If they don't look good to you, they're not going to look good to anybody else. And that goes with any graphics that you're posting as well. If it's blurry, don't post it. If you can't read it, don't post it. We don't want to see pictures where you can see on your phone where it shows that it's 7:10 at night. So make sure you're cropping your pictures. You have to be professional. Also, what is Colette saying here? Our selfies need to be our best, or not physically in the best light. What was I saying, you guys? I need to stop looking at the chat, so maybe you guys can read them for me. when you're posting, I am a huge grammar Nazi, so I will just look at something and just be like, oh my God. So just make sure you're taking the time to proofread your post before you're putting them out there. Check for misspellings. Our phones tell us when we're misspelling a word. Fix it. Make sure it's not run-on sentences. Use your punctuation. Just kind of take a moment to proofread your post before you're putting them out there, because that's another thing. If somebody cannot like make sense of what you're trying to say, they're gonna keep scrolling. You've gotta be professional. Build your brand. Think about, who are you? What sets you apart from somebody else on their newsfeed? You are up against so many other network marketers. You have to figure out a way that you can stand out from the 50 other people on somebody else's newsfeed. Think about how many It Works distributors are on one person's newsfeed. How are you going to stand out to them? They're going to buy into you before they buy into their product. So what is it that you can put out there to where they're going to remember who you are? See, look, I almost clicked on the chat thing. I'll have to wait till the end. And you've got to stand for something. You know, I always say you've got to stand for something or you'll buy into anything. So, and this is where it can be very controversial. We always like to say, don't post anything political. Don't post anything controversial. But if you are passionate about something, post about it. That's who you are. Earlier, Tanya posted today, her kid, some boy touched her kid's butt, her daughter's butt. She went on a rant, not an unprofessional rant, but she was basically showing, like, parents, teacher, children. I'm sorry, but I don't see anything wrong with that. We have to, I mean, we can't just post everything as roses and daisies and la, la, la. Post about things that are real, things that are effective, things that other people can relate to, because that's what's going to get people to comment on your post. So just kind of, you know, pay attention to what you're posting, what's worth it and what's not. I saw the other day, it wasn't an It Works distributor, but it was from another company. They were posting these pornographic pictures. I would die if that was somebody on my team. You're professional. That's not what we want to post. When I say don't be vanilla, that's not the kind of person that I'm talking about. But, you know, just be passionate about what you're posting out there. Look to other leaders to get ideas of what to post, but do not copy and paste word for word of what this leader is posting. Because if something comments, if you do that, somebody comments on your post, they're not wanting to comment on what you're posting. They're wanting to comment on what your leader's posting because they're agreeing with them. Take a clue from what they're posting, take a screen, or not a screenshot, but copy paste it to your notes and modify it to where it fits you. If you see somebody else post a picture of, you know, a product on their countertop, don't take their pictures. Reenact that picture on your countertop. Make it be of you, you guys. We don't want to mimic anybody, but it's okay to use somebody to get ideas. And also take a moment, look back on your Instagram feed, look back on your It Works feed. It's okay to delete. You don't want your feeds to be a It Work, to look spammy or salesy or nothing but memes. You want it to be you. You want it to be selfies. You want it to be pictures of you and your family, of your children, things that mean something to you. So take a moment back to go back and just take a look at your feed. Does it look salesy to you? If so, change it up. Do it now before it's too late. Go to your Facebook, go through and delete stuff that does not matter to you, stuff that you kind of regret posting at one time or another. It's not too late to reinvent yourself, but just take a moment. You're a professional. You need to put yourself out there like you are the professional. And that's all I have to say about that. So we can look at our chats now. Yep, Shelby says, it's fun to get ideas from people, but delete old posts. No billboards. People don't want to follow you if you're a walking It Works billboard. They want to follow you because of who you are. So if you, it's okay, post before and after pictures. It's okay to go back and delete stuff. I like to go back if I see that I'm not getting a lot of, so say I post something at 6 o'clock in the morning and I feel it's a good post. If I don't get any comments or likes, I will delete it and I'll post it at another time later on because maybe there's going to be more people later on. Does anybody else have anything to say?
I was trying not to distract you. I was saying, just like Katie was saying, it needs to be in your best light. Like, yes, good lighting. So it's not dark and it's not blurry and, you know, bad angles. But also in your best light, in a not physical way. Like, don't be super negative and super complainy and super grumpy. And like, if that's all you're doing is just maybe rants or, you know, be in this positive light of what's your goal and how does that person look and act, and how can we be like that? Like, is that, would a diamond portray herself like that on Facebook and Instagram? Or in public, you know what I mean? That's where I was trying to go with that.
Yes.
Yeah, just to go off of what Colette said and like my meaning behind, you know, what I was getting at is look at your picture and does your picture say that I take my products, I believe in my products, I believe in my company, this is how I want to represent myself. Because not only are you representing the company, but you're representing yourself in everything that you do. So if you're taking a picture of yourself and you have, you know, like a bunch of junk behind you, or, you know, it's just not a very appeasing picture for a health and wellness company, don't post it, because that's only going to deter people from liking and commenting your future posts. It's just going to hinder your business. So you kind of have to think and put yourself in the footsteps of the shoes of your customers and what's attractive for them. So just keep that in mind, because I know I have seen some pictures from some people that personally I wouldn't post because it kind of sets you in a bad light. But just keep that in mind and keep growing and learning with every picture that you take. And if you're not sure, again, use your leaders. Send it up to people. Send it to us. Send it to Tiffany and be like, hey, what do you think of this picture? Is this a good picture that I could post with that would make me in the best light possible? We're going to be honest with you. And going off of that, we call this the Tough Love Tiffany session. You guys got to be able to take the criticism and the help that we offer and not be hurt by it. We're only trying to grow you. And that's why, I love when Tiffany does these, because I just connect well with people who are just straight up and say, listen, this is what you're doing wrong. And you have to adjust like that. So please don't take what we say as we're attacking you or anything by any means. We're only here doing this to help you to grow, to make you have a bigger, better business, because we all want you to be successful. So don't ever get hurt by what someone says. And if there is, we're all adults, just address it and move on. And because that's only going to hurt your business in the long run.
Absolutely. And the thing is in this business, you actually have to, and I always say you've got to figure out how to pull out your red, to pull out, kind of like your toughness, because otherwise you're going to get eaten up in this business. You're going to have naysayers out there. You're going to have people comment and talk crap on your posts. You've got to learn how to deal with those people. So we're all about loving this page and showing you what's right and how to get through things. And if something is triggering you to where you feel offended, then maybe it's time you take a step out and figure out, why are you feeling offended? Is it true? It's all learn how to take constructive criticism. And honestly, somebody will send me something and say, does this look too salesy? I've told people, I'm straight up with people. I'll say, honestly, I'd keep scrolling if I were to see this post. And in my opinion, you know how I am. Don't message me unless you want to hear the truth. But it's all about constructive. It's not that I'm trying to hurt anybody's feelings, but it's a harsh world out there. So you've got to learn how to deal with it. Take what you can learn from it and just grow from there. It's all a growing process.
Awesome, you guys. Okay, this was perfect. I love it. The recording will be back in the chat, in the Zoom link recording feed. And it looks like Shelby had also said that there's several in there to watch. There's an awesome March Zoom that talks about attractive marketing. That's a good one to watch. There's so much in there, you guys. Even back in February, we had a huge long list of videos. Learn about your business. Learn how you can make it better. And I'm grateful that you guys are all on here. We had 16 people stay to the end. You're here because you want to learn, and I appreciate all of you, and so does all the leaders on here. So thank you guys. Have a great night. We look forward to seeing what this new week brings, and we'll talk to you later.